Introducing the 2023-2024 Veterans Varsity Cheerleaders, led by Mrs. Elizabeth Ayala and Mrs. Helen Chavez. Valentina Escobedo, 1 year varsity. Trish Reyna, 1 year varsity. Carissa Serrata, 2 year varsity. Megan Buenrostro, 2 year varsity. Maya Inihosa, 1 year varsity. Brianna Barnes, 1 year varsity. Natalie Ruiz, 1 year varsity. Yareli Trevino, 2 year varsity. Abriana Analin, 2 year varsity. Annie Cisneros, 1 year varsity. Shakira Valles, 2 year varsity All American. Ariana Sanchez, 2 year varsity All American. Maria Jose Torres, 2 year varsity. Kendra Rivera, 2 year varsity. Natalia Rojas Ochoa, 2 year varsity All American Cheerleader of the Week. Tatania Marquez, 2 year varsity. Alessandra Huerta, 4 year varsity All American. Salma Monroy, 4 year varsity All American. Samantha Aguirre, 4 year varsity All American. Karen Rodriguez, 4 year varsity All American co captain. Luisa Sampaio, 4 year varsity All American co captain. And Natalie Chavez, 4 year varsity All American captain. Veterans Memorial, faculty, staff, and Mighty Charger student body welcome you, McAllen High Bulldogs. Tonight and always, we are honored and proud to be the namesake of the greatest group of Americans, the men and women of our U.S. military, our veterans, active duty service members, guardsmen, and reservists of the United States, as it is their service that has kept our country safe and free. At halftime, please join us as we bestow upon them the thanks and gratitude that they deserve daily. This evening, we will join as witnesses to one of the greatest pastimes, that is Texas high school football. We wish the Bulldogs an injury-free night and hope that they enjoy the game in the spirit it was intended. Together, let us cheer, stomp, and encourage the young men who will give their all and then some to make their parents, school, and all in attendance proud. Sit back, enjoy the game, and go Chargers!
Those words are as true today as they were then. Throughout this nation's history, America's soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, reserves, and Coast Guardsmen have bravely answered the call to defend our freedom, to aid our friends and allies, and to turn back aggressors. We can never fully repay our debt of gratitude to the more than 650,000 American service members who died in battle, or the 1.4 million who were wounded. We can, however, recognize and thank the 25 million veterans still living today. Continue to read. These words are inscribed on the Korean War Memorial in Washington, D.C. Our nation honors her sons and daughters who answered the call to defend a country they never knew and a people they never met. Those words apply equally to many of our World War I, World War II, Korean, and Gulf Wars, and those protecting us in our borders are overseas veterans as well. They apply to today's active duty service members, tomorrow's veterans, who are helping to maintain peace throughout the world. Today, it is our privilege to say thank you, thank you, and thank you. And happy Veterans Day to all of America's veterans and soldiers, both past and present. To let them know that we appreciate them for their service and honor them for their sacrifices. The price of freedom is high. We cannot afford to forget those willing to pay it. Today, we celebrate America's veterans for keeping this nation, this wonderful nation we live in, the land of the free, the home of the brave. Be aware and always remember, for us, they paid a price. Happy Veterans Day, and thank you, our veterans.
Test. Test. Mic test.
Sacrifice to achieve athletic excellence. We ask that you as spectators consider the time and effort each of these teams have put forth. Cheer these young men, applaud them, but do not, through any of your actions, cause them to doubt the value of athletics. Ask everyone to please now stand and let's take this time to reflect upon tonight's game and the goodness that is granted to all of us. This game belongs to both teams, the Bulldogs and the Chargers, and to the good sportsmanship that they will show today, both on and off the field. We'll ask you at this time, join in a moment of silence, hope for a game free of injuries, and for a safe trip home tonight for everyone. Thank you. Please remain standing for the Veterans Memorial Chargers School Song. Tonight's game is comprised of cadets from Veterans Memorial and Ernie Cottage High School, Marine Corps Junior Reserve Officers Training Corps Program. The Color Guard Commander is Cadet Second Lieutenant John Medema, carrying the Marine Corps colors, Cadet Gunnery Sergeant Carlos Corvero. Rifle bearer is Cadet Corporal Liani Neos. Left rifle bearer is Cadet Sergeant Andrea Rojado. Color Guards under the direction of Sergeant Major Lewis and First Sergeant Ramos. We'd ask everyone to please remove your caps and place your hand over your heart for the presentation of our nation's colors and the singing of our national anthem as led by the Veterans Memorial Sound Station under the direction of Indiana Guerrero.
Mic test. Test. 1, 2.
pull out the chance away. It's been very rainy and wet all day. As officially the long 2023 regular season in the books, and now the big dance, the 5A Division I Texas High School Football State Playoffs. McKay Bulldogs at a 15-5A Division I, coming into this one with a regular season record of 7-3 overall, 4-3, led by head coach Patrick Shelby. Taking on Brownsville Veterans of Moore, led by head coach J.C. Ramirez in his first tenure at the helm, 8-2 overall, 6-0 in district, and 16-5A Division I. Coming in as the one seed of that district, McKay the fourth seed, barely sneaking in. And despite coming into this one fourth seed in district, you can begin to understand that
first round
in 15-5 Division One, known as Murderers Row, with the amount of teams in that district with McCown Memorial, Nicky Rowe, Edinburgh Vella, PSJ, and North, that it was going to be tough to get in. So you sneak in either at the one seed or the fourth seed, consider yourself lucky. But you're going up against a very aggressive Brownsville Veterans Memorial squad. Fresh off a district title under first-year head coach J.C. Ramirez. Players to watch for both squads here for McKay Bulldogs: Joaquin Valdez at quarterback, Jaden Nadet at running back, Will Hawk at defensive back, Heriberto Baldero at defensive end. Tristan Keith over at the wide receiver slot for Brownsville Veterans Memorial: Storm Montoya, Calvin Trevilian, Gilbert Trio, and Jerry Gomez lining up offensively.
McKay Bulldogs have won a toss, elected to receive from the clock side. Gentlemen, one sign of friendship.
So crowd making noise here again. Brownsville Veterans coming to this one in the home red with the white and blue trim. McKay in the classic white with the navy, with the purple and gold trim. And McKay led by head coach Patrick Shelby in his third year at the helm, while in Brownsville Veterans Memorial led by head coach J.C. Ramirez. And once again, temperature, cool one here on a Friday night, Sam, 60 degrees. Temperature fluctuating between the high 50s and low 60s. Brownsville Veterans won the toss. They've elected to defer, so they'll receive the start off the second half, while we'll see Brownsville Vets kick off. And McKay defensively will start things off. And McKay, the fourth seed, coming into this one with a 4-3 district record, while Brownsville Veterans a clean sweep through 16-5A Division I, a 6-0 in their district title win. They had to share the district title in that three-way tie alongside Harlingen South and Wessico East. This year, they won't share anything. They'll take it in themselves. And here we go. It's a sky-high kick. And the Class 5A Division I playoffs are underway. This one going to be muffed and will be picked up at about the one and finally roll out of bounds and a bit of a miscue there. And McKay nearly dodging a bullet as that ball went low. See, looks like he misjudged on the way it was coming down. He couldn't quite get a hand and it took a bounce, and it finally rolled out of bounds.
In the field of play. First down, McKay.
So McKay will be taking over at their own yard, and just like that, the odds stacked against them quickly for the McKay Bulldogs, again led by head coach Patrick Shelby. In that very, very aggressive district of 15-5A Division I, has the heavy hitters like Edinburgh Vella, PSJ North. Edinburgh Vella, PSJ North, Nicky Rowe, McCown Memorial, the crosstown rival, McCown Memorial taking on Harlingen South at Bogus. First and 10 for McKay. They'll go in on a QB keeper. And down to about the 4-yard line. Pick up two. Dead on the tackle there for Brownsville Veterans Memorial.
Gain of 2 second and 8.
Aina 2 brings up second down and 8 here for McKay. Dean Valdez lined up at quarterback. He'll hand off to the right-hand side, trying to get through, and he'll be brought down right at the line. So no gain or loss. They're on the carry. Jaden Nereda, the senior running back, caught and nowhere to go. And third down and 8 coming up here for Brownsville Veteran, or McAllen High, excuse me.
36.
He was able to pick up 2 yards. That brings up third down and 6. Ball now at the 5-yard line. Long pass to the left-hand side, incomplete. Good coverage there by Brownsville Vets. Josh Perez playing some solid defense, and the intended target right there. Tristan Keith, and three and out here as the Matt Kyle offense will come off and the punting unit comes on board. And we'll see the threat on Gilbert Trillo lined up back to return at about the 41-yard line. So two rushes and complete passes, all Matt Kai is able to pick up offensively. They only pick up 4 yards. So fourth and six coming up in the punt. A low line drive punt that takes a bounce at about the 30 and will finally go out of bounds at about the 36-yard line. And we'll see Brownsville Veterans Memorial take over. And what a year they had offensively here, led by the junior quarterback, Storm Montoya, but he didn't do it alone. He had Jerry Gomez to back him up. He had the running threats of Alvin Trevilian, Calvin Trevilian, Cesar Villamontes.
Official's timeout.
And the freshman, Maddox Bond, who all worked their way through, and also the backup quarterback in the form of Sergio Sosa, who comes in on alternate snaps here for Brownsville Vets. Can Brownsville Veterans Memorial picking up the same offense they ran under Kelly Lee at Eastern New Mexico University, who was at Eastern New Mexico, who is now back at E&M. So Matt Kine, their opening drive, they start off at their own 2-yard line, not able to pick up much. Now Brownsville Vets taking over. At the Mack High 36-yard line, so excellent field positioning here for the Bulldogs, or for the Chargers. So defensively, Bronzo Veterans forces a three. Now we'll see what the powerhouse offense. A ground strike offense here incorporated by Kelly Lee, now taken over by J.C. Ramirez. First and 10 for the Chargers at the 36-yard line. Montoya hands off over, finds Alvin Trevilian. Trevilian brought down roughly to about the 34 for a 2-yard pickup. Brings up second down and 8 here for Brownsville Vets. Second down and 7, about a 3-yard pickup now at the 33-yard line. Another handoff to Trevilian. Trevilian trying to cut through traffic. And he'll be down to the 30, so another 3 yards picked up. So that brings up third down and 4. Now coming up here at the 30-yard line for Brownsville Veterans Memorial. So in the opening drive on offense, Mack High only able to pick up 4 yards. Brownsville Veterans already picking up a total of 6 yards on their first two drives, on their first two plays of their first drive, excuse me. So third and 4 here from the 30-yard line. Montoya under center. He'll pitch it off to the left-hand side. That's Trillo. Trillo with a wide-open gate at the 15, at the 10, and finally shoved out of bounds inside the Mack High 5. And Trillo will be ruled down at the 4-yard line, and just like that, the Charger offense cooking early on.
Offside on the defense, number 42. Penalty decline, result of the play, first down.
So a flag, late flag during the play goes against Mack High. So Mack High will be forced to take on defense at the 3-yard line. But Brownsville Veterans, 3 plays in, already knocking on the door. And in 3 plays, Mack High was only able to pick up a total of 4 yards. We've already picked up a total of 32 yards here. Brownsville Veterans on their first drive. First and goal from the 3-yard line. Toss off to Trillo. Trillo trying to power his way through. He'll stretch and the ball will come loose. And Trillo will be ruled down at the 1, so right when his knee hit the ground, he tried to stretch out for an extra yard to get across the plane. And the ball came loose, but he was already ruled down, so Mack High nearly builds in. Bronze Letter, excuse me, dodges a bullet as Mack High almost capitalized on a would-be fumble. So second and goal now from the 1-yard line. Montoya going to go on a QB keeper. He's going to get pushed in. Touchdown, Brownsville Veterans. And the Chargers on drive number 1 drive it in 36 yards. And it's capped off on a 1-yard run. A QB keeper by Storm Montoya was pushed in by the backfield. And it's a 6-0 lead with 9:09 left to go in the first. Roman Reyna lining up to kick off. Reyna lining up for the PAT. kick. Nearly blocked that one. Line drive through the goalposts. And with 9:09 left to play here in this first quarter, Brownsville Veterans drives it in 36 yards and a couple passes and a big run by Gilbert Trillo, capped off on a one-yard run by Sturm Montoya here on KBSDI-TV's coverage of the Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs. Rain on kicking off, and this kick well high, and that one going to be returned from about the 25-yard line. Mack High trying to drive this one back. That's Tristan Keith trying to drive it down, and he gets brought down to the 32-yard line. So excellent field position here. As Brownsville Veterans, they started off from their, or Mack High started off for their own one-yard line, and they were only able to pick up 4 yards before they were forced to punt the ball. To enter Brownsville Veterans, they take over at the Mack High 36, and they'll drive it into the end zone. So now Mack High on drive number two with a lot more field positioning and a lot more room to work with. That's Joaquin Valdez, the junior quarterback, lining up. Two junior quarterbacks facing off. Valdez, he'll go for a pass to the left-hand side. Pass completed the cross there to Obed Alvarez. Alvarez down to about the 36-yard line, so a 4-yard pickup easily brings up second down and 6 here for Mack High. A little bit of a feeling out process here. If you're Mack High, you're able to see what Brownsville Veterans can do here on second down and 6. Handoff to the left-hand side on the carry, Jaden Herrera. And a down all the way to about the 38-yard line. 2 more yards picked up. That'll bring up third down and 4 here for Mack High. Third down and 3 coming up. Valdez lined up in the shotgun. 2 receivers on his left, 1 on the right-hand side. Man in motion, another handoff here. To Herrera, and Herrera trying to stretch through. He brought down to the 41-yard line. So a 2-yard pickup once again brings up 4th down and 1. If you're Coach Patrick Shelby, you're met up with a difficult choice early on. You roll the dice to go for it on 4th down. So only 1 yard to work with. And the punting unit comes on board. Trillo's back to return. He's at about the 27-yard line for Brownsville Veterans. And a timeout going to be called here by Brownsville Veterans. So we'll take a quick break here on KBSDI-TV. Don't go anywhere. Brownsville probably on. 4th and 1. So timeout called by BVM. Mack High will decide to go for it, and the Brownsville Charger defense standing their ground here. And the first 4th down conversion attempt of the game fails for Mack High. They'll go 0-for-1 on the 4th down conversions.
Official timeout for measurement.
Now a timeout call, and the chain crew is going to come out here.
Yeah, this side.
First down marker at the 42-yard line. So just like that, Brownsville Veterans, they call a timeout to readjust defensively and able to hold off McAllen for now. He gets it to go here. The chain crew set to come out and try to get a measurement. First down started off, or the drive started off at the 32-yard line. And the crew coming out here is the first down marker off at the 42. We're able to see here if they're close in or not. And that's going to be short, and Brownsville Veterans comes up big defensively, so they force a three and out on drive number one. Drive number two, they shut the door on fourth and one. Measurement brought out to confirm it. First and 10 here from the 41-yard line. And off down the middle. Easy 7 yards picked up. Alvin Trevilian on the carry. Trevilian on the way down to about the 34-yard line. Gain of 6, bringing up second down and 4 here. Or gain of 7. Gain of 7, bringing up second down and 3 from the 34-yard line. So again, Brownsville Veterans defense comes up big twice. The opening drive for Mackay. They're forced to go 3 and out. Then on drive number 2, the Chargers shut the door on 4th and 1. So 2nd and 3 after the 7-yard carry by Trevilian. They go again to Trevilian, who tries to work his way down the field. He'll get enough for the first down and more as he's all the way to the 25-yard line for a 9-yard pickup and a fresh set of downs here for the Brownsville Veterans Memorial Chargers. Thank you for joining us here. KBSD-ITV's coverage of the 2023 UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs coming to you from Sam's Memorial Stadium. First and 10 from the 25-yard line after a 9-yard run by Trevilian. Montoya will pitch it off to Trillo. Trillo with a lot of coverage. Trillo makes one defender miss. Trillo runs into a second, and he's finally going to be brought down by two Bulldogs to about the 13-yard line. Initially on the tackle, Andres Barrera, the senior defensive back. So Brownsville Veterans here again. They started off at the 36 on drive one. Drive two, they start 5 yards further at the 41. That hasn't seemed to faze them so far as this Charger offense has been taking over so far. So first and 10 from the 13-yard line. Trying to cut through the other side, trying to cut through traffic. And down the way quickly to about the 7-yard line. Brings up second down, coming up second down and 3, a 7-yard pickup. Barrera once again on the stop. He brought down Trillo earlier and he brings him down again. So second and 3 now from the 6-yard line with 6:04 left to play here in this first quarter. Montoya lined up under center. Two receivers lined up on one either side. Hand off to Trillo. Trillo finds an opening and Trillo will run in. Touchdown Brownsville Veterans. And the Chargers in business early on as they go 2-for-2 on scoring drives. This time it's a 6-yard run by Gilbert Trillo, the senior. You see the line of blocks right there. Initial block right there we saw by Mark Samano, Jr. Opened that window to the right-hand side, and Trillo was able to waltz his way into the end zone. Reyna back here lined up for the PAT. Line, ripped of a squib kick. That one goes high and through. And with 5:53 left to go, the Chargers up two possessions here, 14-zip, 5:53 left to go in the first on Friday Night Football here on KBSDI-TV's coverage of the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football Playoffs. Be back after this. I 53 left to go here in the first quarter. Matt Mackay down two possessions will return the ball to start things off. And Andres Vareda watched that sail into the end zone, but Brownsville Veterans Memorial, ground and pound offense. First, it's Storm Montoya on a one-yard run on second and goal. And on second and three from the six-yard line, it's Gilbert Trillo who finds the end zone to make it 14-0. The Chargers up in business. Thank you for joining us here once again on KBSD-ITV's coverage of the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs. The road to Arlington beginning now, and a lot of Valley teams, the favorites this year. San Benito, Wesico, one of them being Brownsville Veterans and PSJ North. Top four teams arguably in 6A and 5A. So Matt Kai here on their third drive of the night, starting off the 25-yard line, first and 10. Valdez lined up in the shotgun with two receivers on his left, one on the right-hand side. Matt in motion, that's Saavedra. Valdez with a pass to the left-hand side. That one batted away. That'll bring up second down and good coverage there by Gilbert Trillo, the two-way player who will start off offensively, also defensively. Ranks up a pass to the intended target. This brings up second and 10 here for Matt Kai from the 25-yard line. Despite Matt Kai being able to pick up some yards, they haven't been phased one bit by Browns Veterans, who was able to shut the door on them twice on a three and out on a fourth and one call. Valdez on a handoff, this time to Herrera. Herrera trying to cut through traffic. Herrera down roughly to about the 28-yard line for a pickup of three, bringing up second down and seven, or third down and seven, excuse me, for Matt Kai. Third down and seven, Valdez rolling to his right. He'll go deep downfield. That's going to be incomplete. Diego de Saavedra, the senior, the intended target, just had a hand on it, dived for it, but couldn't quite bring it down. And that sets up another three and out on the McKay Bulldogs, failing to get any offense going on their first three drives of the night as this Charger defense has been relentless so far. They always say a good offense is backed by a good defense. That's been the case so far for the Chargers. Been able to slam the door on Matt Kai and also pick up two touchdowns themselves. High snap and a line drive punt. This one will take a bounce at about the 46, and Trillo will watch it roll, and he'll let it roll to a stop, and it'll be brought down to about the 24-yard line. Tapping it for Matt Kai there was Blow Flatow, the sophomore, who stops it down. So Brownsville Veterans will be taking over from their farthest point tonight, their own 25-yard line. They started off at the McKay 36 and at the McKay 41. And for the first time tonight, they'll start off possession. They'll start off a drive from their own side of the field at their own 25. Montoya dropping back, deep pass, finds Trillo. Trillo with a lot of traffic at the 50, to the 40, to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, and say goodbye, touchdown, Brownsville Veterans. One play is all it takes here for Brownsville Vets. Again, we said it earlier, they started off at the McKay 36, McKay 41. The first time they start off their own side of the field at the 25, they go 75 yards to a pass to Gilbert Trillo. And Montoya with his second touchdown tonight, his first touchdown pass. Trillo also with his second touchdown pass, or second touchdown, but his first touchdown reception of the night. And the Chargers putting up a clinic here with 4:52 left to go in the first, as his Brownsville Veterans offense has been very relentless, and they've been backed by a very potent defense. 4:52 left to go here. You're watching Friday Night Football on KBSDI-TV. Don't go anywhere.
set to kick off, 26, Ramon Wayne.
Ramon Reyna on the kickoff. This one going to sail into the end zone. Once again, Andres Barrera watches it go, but Brownsville Veterans Memorial. What a night for them so far offensively. We're not even at the end of the first quarter. So with 5:53 left to go in the first, they pick up their second touchdown on a six-yard run by Trillo. Then a minute and a second later with 4:52 left to go, Montoya finds Gilbert Trillo 75 yards for a touchdown pass to drive it in, making it 21-0. And again, it was the first time they started off at their own side of the field. First play, no problem. 75-yard touchdown pass. So Matt Kai trying to find the groove here on drive number four of the night. They're 0 for 3 on their first three drives. Pass going to be batted away. And that's going to be completed and caught by Arena.
Pass complete number 82, Nick Karam.
Correction, Nick Karam there on the reception. Brownsville veterans here, they've been able to shut the door on Mackay effectively, defensively and on offense. Storm Montoya and Gilbert Trill, they both have two touchdowns apiece. Another handoff here down the middle to Herrera, and Herrera will break in for Mackay's first down conversion of the night. As they get down all the way to about the 39-yard line. Nicky Rodriguez there on the stop. And both teams fresh off a regional semifinal appearance. Valdez dropping back, he'll pass to the left-hand side. Once again, this time you'll find Simon Pardo.
Pass complete on line number 21, pushed out of bounds by Martinez,
number 6. Angel Anaya, correction here, the senior wide receiver on the reception. Another 10-yard gain, so now to the 49 they go. First and 10 here for Mackay, two first down conversions on this drive. Hand off to Herrera, zips to his left-hand side, and he'll be brought down to about the 49 for a two-yard pickup. And for the first time tonight, Matt Kai crosses into Brownsville Veterans territory on offense. And as I was saying earlier, both teams fresh off regional semifinal appearances. Matt Kai losing to Corpus Christi Veterans, who would eventually beat PSJ North, who beat Brownsville Vets in their regional semifinal matchup. So second down and 8 from the 49-yard line. Quick fire pass to the left-hand side. That's going to be completed. And down quickly to the 45-yard line for a 4-yard pickup. Brings up third down and 4 here for Mackay.
Nice reception by Tristan Keith.
Tristan Keith, the junior receiver. We've seen them link up all year long. This brings up second down and 4 here from the 45-yard line. Mackay looks like they've been waking up in a sense. They've already been a lot more efficient here on this drive. They picked up two first down conversions, and they finally crossed in the Brownsville of Veterans territory for the first time. Valdez rips a pass, and that's batted away and incomplete. Josh Bett is a senior defensive back for the Chargers. Breaks it up, and fourth down calling here for the Mackay Bulldogs, and the offense will trot off, and the special teams unit comes on board. Saida Esparza back to kick this one off. Trillo back to return. Esparza off at about the 42-yard line. Trillo back at about the BVN 10. Good punt. This one a line drive punt and going to be taking a bounce at about the 20. And an awkward bounce. Look, a very long, awkward bounce. And it's finally going to be situated at about the 6-yard line. So we'll see Brownsville Veterans take over. For the second time tonight, they'll start off. In their first two drives, they started off in Mackay territory at the 36 and at the 41. Then on drive number three, they start off with their own 25, and Trillo gets a 75-yard reception from Montoya. So now they'll start off from inside the 10 at the 6-yard line, so they'll have 94 yards to try to make it to the promised land. Mansell Veterans are a very potent team offensively and defensively. Montoya lined up under center, first and 10 from the 6-yard line. Another handoff here. Good opening by Trevilian. Trevilian trying to cut through. Trevilian down roughly at about the 16-yard line, so he'll easily pick up 10. Turning up first and 10 now from the BBM 16. 2.5 left to play. Again, it's been all Brownsville veterans in his first quarter. 3 touchdowns, 1 by Montoya on a rush. Trillo then picked up a 6-yard rush. Then Montoya connected to Trillo, so they each have 2 touchdowns. They each have a reception and a rushing touchdown. So first and 10 from the 17-yard line. 2:20 left to play in the first quarter. Pitch off to the right-hand side. Good movement right there. Here comes a lot of coverage. Jose Sanchez trying to cut through, get hit hard. And a flag on the play and a lot of contact thereafter. Jose Sanchez there on the pitch by Montoya. Gets a lot of ground. He gets down to about the 41-yard line, but a bit of a late hit after, as you see on the bottom of your screen.
Personal foul.
Right, forced out of bounds.
Late hit out of bounds. Number four, the defense. 15 yards.
Brought down there by Nick Moss, the senior defensive end for Mack High. Sanchez already crossing out.
24-yard gain by Sanchez on the play.
So first and 10 here. They'll go over to the 44-yard line, 10 yards on that personal foul against Mack High. So initially at the 41, they go 10 yards into the 44-yard line in the Mack High territory. So initially at the 6, now at the 44 in Bulldog territory. Another handoff to Trevilian. Trevilian trying to power his way through. Trevilian trying to stretch across. And he's going to be down to about the 36-yard line for an 8-yard pickup.
8-yard gain
on the play. Handoff here once again. Down to about the 31-yard line. So 3 yards enough to make it to the first down. So first and 10, you're down to the 31-yard line as the wind's starting to pick up briefly here at Sam's. Again, hasn't rained yet. It's been raining all day here in Brownsville in the South Texas area. Montoya dropping back, zips a pass down the middle. That's going to be completed. And Trevilian on the reception, or correction, Nick DeWad, the senior tight end, making a pass. I think it was Trevilian because he ran the same route, but DeWad brings it down.
That's
an 11-yard reception, enough for a first down. So Brownsville veterans for the fourth time tonight in the red zone. First and 10 here from the 20 with a minute left to play in this first quarter. Montoya with the handoff down the middle of Trevilian. Trevilian trying to power his way through traffic down quickly to about the 16-yard line with the gain of 4. Brings up second down and 6 here for BVM.
In on the tackle, Trevilian, number 15, Oliver Schwartz.
So second down and 6. Montoya dropping back, going vertical downfield. That's going to be incomplete. Gary Gomez, a senior and the intended target, tried to get a one-handed catch, but a little too outstretched, and this brings up third down and 6 with 25 seconds left to play. 21 zip here as we near the end of the first quarter, but a very dominant gameplay on offense and defense for Brownsville veterans. They haven't forced a turnover yet so far, but they've forced a 3-and-out, and they've slammed the door shut, and despite Mack High getting a lot of ground against them, they were able to shut down the momentum. Another toss to Trevilian. Trevilian trying to go, and he's finally going to be brought down. Correction, that's Mark Samano, the junior.
Mark Samano tackled by number 4, Nathan Woodchuck. 7-yard
gain,
first and goal.
Final 10 seconds will wind down. We'll watch the time wind down after a very lengthy first quarter and a very productive quarter here for Brownsville Veterans Memorial. One quarter in the books, and it's Brownsville veterans up 21-0 over Mack High. We'll be back with the second quarter here of the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs here on KBSDI-TV.
Alaskan Gold Lanai.
Welcome back here to KBZI TV's coverage of the Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs. Montoya on a QB keeper to start off the second quarter, and he'll pick up three easily. And Montoya a bit slow to get up.
Official's timeout for an injury.
So Aidas Spars on the stop, and Montoya slow to get up as he was tripped up. We'll take a quick break here on KBSDI TV. Thank you for joining us. If you're just tuning in, we'll break down what we've seen so far in the first quarter. The crowd has gone silent here at Sam Stadium. Montoya here on a QB keeper on first and goal from the 9-yard line. Roll it down to the right-hand side. Esparza tripped him up, and Montoya landed awkwardly. Was a bit slow to get up. Was assisted with medical personnel, and he's able on his feet. He's up in his own power. He's on the backup quarterback warming in. Sergio Sosa, the junior. He's already getting some reps ready in the direction of J.C. Ramirez. Sergio Sosa now scooting in here. So second and goal from the 6-yard line. They'll toss off here to Gilbert Trillo. Trillo going to try to find the window, and he's going to be forcing his way in. Touchdown, Ronzo Vets. And Gilbert Trillo already with touchdown number 3 on the night. His second rushing touchdown, this time a 6-yarder. Shades of his first touchdown tonight, which is a 6-yarder on second and goal. And on second and goal, once again from the 6-yard line, he powers his way through. He just beats in Sebastian Ramirez. He was finally brought down as we're waiting here, the PAT from Ron Arena. Now one zips through here, and to start off the second quarter, 22 seconds in, Browns of Veterans up 28-0 off Trillo's third touchdown of the night. You're watching Friday Night Football here on KBZI TV. Don't go anywhere. Right here, scores coming in across the other bi-district matchups. Larbluff for PSJ Memorial 31-7. Mission Veterans over Valley View 28-0. That one in the first quarter. Westlake and Mission a 6-0 lead. And Westlake East, the Red Couch, Redmond Vela 9-7. All right, Esparza returning it down to the 21-yard line. And Gilbert Trillo, the story of the game so far, already 3 touchdowns, 2 rushing touchdowns, and 1 touchdown reception. His first touchdown, a 6-yard rushing touchdown, and his latest, a 6-yard rushing touchdown, and both on second and goal from the 6. As we'll see, Brownsville Veterans line up back on defense, and Mackay on their last drive, a lot of momentum brewing. They were able to pick up 2 first-down conversions, the first time they picked up a first-down conversion all night. And they were able to get into Charger territory, but BVN picked up some momentum and shut the door quickly. This brings up first and 10 here from the 21-yard line. Another handoff to Inida. Correction, QB keeper there by Joaquin Valdez. I think it was an initial handoff, but a fake handoff correction.
8-yard gain.
Third down and two coming up here for Mack High. 10:55 left to play in this first half. And Gilbert Trillo, the story of the day so far, three touchdowns, two rushing and one touchdown reception, his largest being a 75-yard rushing touchdown. So third down and one here from the 30. Quick fire pass to the right-hand side. First and 10 here from the 37-yard line. Valdez, a quick pass. Looking to find Obed Alvarez. Known by his teammates as Max.
Personal foul on the defense, number 6. 15 yards.
There's a late hit
first
there
down
on Alvarez. Who tried to bring the ball down and was shoved. This ball went through his hands. He was coming down. He was shoved late. And it moves up the chains here. And Mack High once again will get into Charger territory. This time to about the 48-yard line. It was first and 10 at their own 49 where they picked up 2 yards to the 49-yard line. So Valdez here on a jet sweep, hands it off this time to Alvarez. Alvarez trying to find a path down the middle, and he'd be brought down to about the 40-yard line for a quick 8 yards to bring up second down and two here for Mack High. And Mack High has been a lot more efficient here so far in these late couple drives. Their first three drives weren't able to do much. Drives 4 and 5, they're able to knock on the door, and High Mount going to be called, or a flag on the play.
Before snap. False start offense, number 63.
False start on the offense.
5 yard penalty, still second down.
A true first flag Mack High has had all night offensively. They've had a flag earlier, which is a block in the back defensively, and that was it. So only their second flag of the night, but their first offensive flag. So second down and 7 here now with the 45-yard line. Initially picked up 8 yards there on the run by Alvarez. So Valdez lined up in the shotgun with two receivers. And now an early jump on the BBM side.
Before snap.
Correction off.
55.
I saw an early jump there on BBM side. But right before they jumped, Mack High also jumped. So another 5 yards lost. So it was initially second down and 2. Now second and 7. Now second down and 12. So 10 yards lost on false start calls, consecutive false start calls for Mack High. Bulldogs now with 4 receivers, 2 on either side lined up. 1 in the backfield, Valdez lined up in the shotgun. Man in motion from the right to the left, it's Alvarez. Valdez dropping back, pressure comes in. He'll be forced to go on the move. He'll find a window and he'll run into a defender. He's quickly brought down by Andrew Quintero. As the pressure came in from both sides and Valdez was forced to go on the move and he ran right into Quintero, and a waiting sophomore quickly brought him down, so like they lost about 1 yard. This brings up third down and 13, ball now at the 49 yard. So on the drive they had a lot of potential once again where they were able to move the ball, they were killed by 2 crucial false start calls and a 1 yard loss as Valdez was brought down by Quintero. So third down and 13 from the 49-yard line. Another handoff. And quickly brought down in Anaya. Nowhere to go. Brought down back to the line of scrimmage. This brings up fourth down now coming up. So bring that fourth down and 14. Another loss. After picking up 8 yards initially after they got a call against Brownsville veterans to help them out. And Alvarez, who picked up an 8-yard run all the way to the 40-yard line. They had 2 consecutive false starts and couldn't get nothing offensively. So now it's 4th and 14 coming up. Esparza with a line drive punt. This one going to be taking a bounce at about the 13. It will sail into the end zone. They were trying to keep it in. It'll take over here from the 25-yard line. So at 1st and 10 here from the 20-yard line, Brownsville veterans will take over. They last found the end zone. And Brownsville veterans offense, 4 for 4. Call that the Wendy's order. Or for four on scoring drives. They found the end zone each of their four times on offense. So first and 10 here from the 20-yard line. Hand off to Trevilian. Trevilian will pick up a solid 13 yards to the 33-yard line after starting off the 20. 13 yards quickly renews the drive here for Browns of Veterans. And a Charger offense has been a lot more efficiently having been able to take over. First and 10 here from the 33-yard line. 7.5 left to play in this first half. Good reverse back to Sosa. Sosa firing it deep downfield. Caught! Inside the 25. And Jerry Gomez making an outstanding play right there as they flip back to Sergio Sosa, who was able to drive that back. So you saw they handed it off to Trevilian, and Trevilian flipped it back over to Sosa. And you see a perfect dime pass, and Jerry Gomez, an outstanding diving grab. And now with the 24-yard line, they take over. And they go on another handoff here, this time to Trevilian. And Trevilian has been the workhorse offensively here for Aldo Veterans Memorial. The Chargers here again, very offensively. He's been guiding the offense, but Gilbert Trillo has been putting the icing on the cake with his four touchdowns. So Trevilian and Trillo have been carrying the load offensively of the running game. Sorm Montoya out here recently, was taken out earlier. Fell a bit awkwardly on his right-hand side. Sergio Sosa, the interim quarterback of the QB keeper, brought down here to about the 18-yard line. On second down and 8. Brings up third down and 4, ball now to the 18-yard line. Third and four now coming up here for Brownsville Veterans Memorial, and the Chargers continuing right where they left off is a very dominant offense so far. Sosa lined up, tosses it off to Trillo on the right-hand side. Trillo has a line of blockers. He forced out of bounds roughly to about the 14, 13-yard line.
First down.
So 5 yards picked up on that third and four, brings up first and 10 now to the 13. So the 18 to 13 on those 5 yards by Trillo, and he's been also the leading man here with the 4-3 touchdowns on the night, 2 rushing touchdowns and 1 reception overnight with 5:50 left to go on the 13-yard line. Play clock at 12 seconds here for Brownsville Veterans. Sosa hands off here to Belmontes. Belmontes has a line of blockers. He'll try to find his way through, but he's going to be brought down to about the 3-yard line. He'll easily pick up 10 on his first play. It's first time touching a ball tonight. He'll pick up 10, and that makes up a first and goal here for Browns Veterans, and the Chargers have been very dangerous here from first and goal. 3 of their 4 touchdowns have all been on first and goal scenario, or second and goal scenarios to be exact. Montoya scored on second and goal from the 1. Trillo scored twice on second and goal from the 6. 3 of the 4 touchdowns have come from inside the 10-yard line for Brownsville Veterans Memorial. Montoya back in the game. He'll hand off down the middle on a touchdown, Brownsville Vets. 2-yard run, number 6, Jaime Martinez. Jaime Martinez, the senior running back, steps in. He'll get his first touchdown of the night. And the Chargers now at 5 straight touchdowns, making it 34-zip with 5:18 left to go here in the second. Roman Reyna lining up here for the kick. A line drive field goal up and in down the middle. And with 5:18 left to play, Brownsville Veterans running the field here, offense and defensively. 35-0, you're watching the Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs on KBSDI-TV.
Hace 19 años desde que tuvimos un ajuste del costo de vida para empleados educativos ya jubilados. Vote sí por la propuesta 9. La votación anticipada comienza el 23 de octubre.
Okay. scores. Second quarter, West Grove East 9, Edgar Villa 7. Arnold Southhawks 9, McAllen Memorial Mustangs 7. West Grove Panthers 12, Mission Eagles 0. Late second quarter score, Portisville Tarpons 14, Robstown 13.
Back here on KBSDI TV, the scores coming in from across the valley here. The Class Miami Division 1 playoffs between Matt Kine and Brownsville Veterans, the bye district ground. Driving it off down this time on the return, Bermudez. Or Finn Henderson, excuse me. There's two sixes lined up. It's Finn Henderson. Finn Henderson there on the return, down quickly to about the 33-yard line. Good return pickup there. And with 5:11 left to go, a 35-0 lead here for Brownsville Veterans Memorial. Again, question for Mackay, how do you stop this potent Charger squad? Quick fire pass to the right-hand side. Obed Alvarez there on the return, known as Max Alvarez's teammates. The senior wide receiver driving it down 8 yards, or 9 yards, correction. Brings up second down and one on a 9-yard reception by Avides. Valdez lined up in the shotgun. Two receivers on his left-hand side. They'll go on a handoff.
Anaya tackled by 55.
Rodriguez there bringing down Anaya, who just gets enough for the first down. Again, Mack High. And the tempo we've seen so far, the bit of a pattern we've seen for the, so far in these past couple drives, every time Mack High gets the ball rolling, every time they get the wheel turning, Brownsville Veterans is able to shut them down, and we've saw it. Well, they actually shut themselves down with those two false start calls, and the Charger defense just cleaned up the mess right there. And a flag on the play, and another false start quickly against Mack High.
Before snap, false start office, number 77. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And multiple false start calls coming in here against Mack High. And we saw that was what killed them in that last drive. They had a lot of momentum. They picked up a quick second, first and 8 yards on first and 10. And they picked up two false starts. Here's a deep pass downfield by Valdez, and Alvarez will wheel it in. He'll break away. Touchdown, Mack High.
Touchdown, Bulldogs.
And just like that, the tempo turns, and for the first time, the Bulldogs coming into this game a little late, but they hit a huge, huge pass. 59-yard touchdown pass there to Max Alvarez. And just like that, Mack High is able to turn the tempo, and for the first time tonight, the Bulldogs find the promised land. And talk about it once again quickly, as we saw these past couple drives. There's an expression that's called, good things come to those who wait. Last couple drives for Mack High, they were shut down each time. They were able to get momentum, and it finally pays off as Max Alvarez picks up a huge 59-yard reception. Gossett is lining up for the PAT. That kick is up, and it just squeaks through. But with 4:08 left to go, Mack High says there'll be no shutout, as once again, Max Alvarez reels in a 59-yard touchdown pass. You're watching the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs on KBSDI TV. With 4:08 left to go here, Mack High scores as Joaquin Valdez finds Max Alvarez on a 59-yard touchdown pass to make it 35-7. So still plenty of time for Mack High to try to get some momentum going, trying to turn this around. It's been a very nightmarish start for them. Last year in the Bay District, they got past Harlingen South. They made it all the way to the regional semis where they fell to Corpus Christi Veterans. And Brownsville Veterans, they fell to PSJ North on this field right after Thanksgiving. As here's a huge, a little bit of a slow kick, and this one maybe returned roughly to about the 40-yard line. Yo Silvera there on the return. So once again here, we saw that reception there. Joaquin Valdez finding Max Alvarez on a 59-yard touchdown pass. He was able to break away from Trillo, who has had a lot of coverage so far tonight. He's been the primary also man, go-to man on defense as a safety and also as a corner, and he had coverage, lockdown coverage there as Alvarez was able to break away just momentarily enough to make the catch and find the end zone. So first and 10 from the 40-yard line. Montoya and company come in, toss off to the right-hand side. Trillo there, and Trillo brought down, and for the first time tonight, Ronzo Veterans brought down behind the line. Down quickly here to about the 38-yard line. So the first time they get negative yardage is they're down all the way to the 38-yard line for a loss of two, bringing up second down and 12 here for Ronzo Veterans. Second down and 12 here from the 38-yard line. Montoya coming in. Montoya gets away from one defender, gets away from another. Montoya, and Montoya brought down for a loss. And Matt Kine's defense all of a sudden with the renewed vigor is able to force negative yardage. And for the first time tonight, Anzu Veterans has lost 5 yards on offense. Initially down at the 40, now down to the 34-yard line, so make that 6 yards. They've lost a total of 6 on negative. They haven't lost at all. It was a bit of a very rare thing to see for them to lose yardage. They haven't lost yardage all game. They finally lose 6. Very rare of them to see, let alone all season. They've been one of those teams that have been able to move progressively offensively. So third and 16 from the 34-yard line. Charger faithful making some noise. Montoya dropping back. Here's a screen pass. That's batted away. And Jerry Gomez made the catch, but he couldn't quite hold on. You know, dropping up for the first time tonight. Bronzeville Veterans forced a punt after getting being taken off guard by Matt High, using that momentum from the touchdown, carrying it over to defense, and they forced a 3-and-out, including a loss of 6 yards and a nearly picked off ball.
Back to punt formation number 90,
Max Cordova. Max Cordova back to punt. Andres Barrera back to return. Cordova back to punt. Plenty of time for the punt. This one will get across. And Barrera will watch it bounce out. And it'll finally roll out of bounds at about the 21-yard line. So Mackay takes over at their own 21-yard line. Talk about turning the momentum, keeping the momentum going. A 59-yard touchdown pass from Joaquin Valdez to Max Alvarez on Mack High's 6th drive of the night. Then quickly offensively on defense, they turn it around and they force BBM to go 3-and-out and maybe force a loss of yards. So the Bulldogs were just able to catch the Chargers off guard. And first and 10 from the 21-yard line. Still plenty of ball game left to go. Go to a handoff to Anaya. So Naya able to just make it back to the line. Brings up second down coming up here for Mackay. Quintero and Maldonado on the two-man stop. Brings up second down and 10. We saw Jaden Neda start off the running here for Mackay, but ever since then it's been Angel and Naya as he took over midway through the first. Maldez dropping back. A lot of coverage here from his line. He'll go deep downfield. That's going to be batted away and nearly caught. As Diego de Saavedra had that one batted away early on, couldn't quite hold it on. We saw it was Jaime Martinez who had a hand on it. Saavedra tried diving onto it, but couldn't quite bring it down. This brings up third down and 10. So an incomplete pass for on the drive. This is seventh drive of the night, excuse me. Matt Kine picks up a ball. We'll swing down momentarily. Here comes third down and 10. Pass batted away one more time and two back-to-back near picked off plays. Brings up fourth and 10, so both offenses go 3-and-out in their last two drives. Esparza back to punt, Trillo back to return. So as I was saying before, I got a bit tongue-tied. On this last drive, on drive number 7 for Matt Kye, they had a no-gain run by Anaya. Then two back-to-back incomplete passes, a punt. I think it was a bit of a lone line punt. And Trillo trying to get the ball. He can't quite hold on to it. And the ball's still coming loose. And Bronzeville Veterans is able to get it. Trillo couldn't quite bring it down. He got hit as he got it. And the ball knocked away again. And Matt Kye able to control it. Jerry Gellman is able to pounce on it right before two Bulldog defenders came in. And they'll start off now at the 26-yard line. First and 10 here from the 27-yard line. Good handoff down the middle. Here's Trevilian. Trevilian breaks away at the 40, to the 30, to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Brownsville Veterans. Massive, massive play. 73-yard touchdown run by Trevilian. And the junior fullback finds a path down the middle and got away from one defender. Now it's all it took. He's able to drive that one back 73 yards to the house. They'll skip a drive to go three and out, but they go right back to work here as it's Trevilian and picks up a huge 73-yard TD run. And the PAT is no good. And it'll make it 41-7 with 1:25 left to go here. You're watching KBSDI-TV's coverage of the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football Playoffs.
Score,
1:25 left to play here in this second quarter, and Brownsville Veterans Memorial, after going three and out their last drive, first play of drive number seven, Alvin Trevillon gets a 73-yard touchdown run to make it 41-7 over Mack High. Roman Reyna failing the PAT. 1:25 left to play. We saw Brownsville Veterans Memorial able to bounce back and see Mack High do the same as they had a touchdown. And then their next drive, they go three and out as well. Long return quickly here from at the 14-yard line. That's Saeed Esparza trying to drive it back, and Esparza nowhere to go. Brought down roughly two, about the 28-yard line. Or to the 3-yard line, excuse me. Let's see the 24. Let's think about the 30, 23, excuse me. Esparza has been returning kicks so far tonight. He's also been one of the leading men to kick off here. He's been primary returner. He's also been a punter here tonight for Mack High. Mack High looking to regain that spark they had earlier. Of course, the lone touchdown, that 59-yard bomb from Valdez Alvarez. That's first and 10 from the 23-yard line now coming in. Valdez goes on a handoff to the left-hand side. Anaya there on the carry. Anaya just able to make it back to the line. So shades of the last drive. It was first and 10. Anaya was only able to make it back to the line of scrimmage. And on the next two plays, incomplete passes that were nearly picked off at Brownsville Veterans. So second and 10 here from the 23-yard line. 55 seconds left to go in this first half. Valdez fires a pass off to Keith, and he finds him. And Tristan Keith there on the reception down to about the 32-yard line.
Stop 16, Tyson Reels.
9 yards there, brings up third down and one. So third down and one now coming up here for Mack High. Valdez dropping back one more time. He'll find Keith, and Keith will make the reception and step out of bounds and stop the time momentarily at 35 seconds left. I'd like to remind you to tune in here to the KBSDI-TV Halftime Show. Recap the first half of what we've seen. We'll go scoring drive by scoring drive and try to get some scores around the Rio Grande Valley on a very busy night. Busy night here in the bi-district round. We've had some games last night. We'll talk about those matchups last night as well. Of course, this game in 5A Division 1. 35 seconds left to go in this first half. Valdez dropping back on first and 10. He'll pump fake. Pressure comes in. This one batted away and nearly picked off. That was Damian Rodriguez broke through the line. Chase Valdez was able to have to throw the ball in an off-balanced form. Sets up third down and one now coming up with 30 seconds left to go. So the incomplete pass stops the play. Only 5 seconds burned off the clock. Play clock at 19 seconds. So third down and one coming up. Quick pass to Keith. Keith trying to get through. Keith trying to stretch out of bounds. And Matt Kine still with three timeouts. But time will stop as they move up the pylon, move up the chains.
Timeout, Matt Kine. That's the first in the first half.
And despite time stopping on the first down, Matt Kine will burn their first timeout. Browns veterans touched their first timeout early on in the first quarter. They've yet to touch a second timeout, but both teams with two timeouts remaining. And 25 seconds left to go. Matt Kine now sets up first and 10 at the 47-yard line. PSJ and Los Fresnos. PSJ up 21-0 over the Falcons in the bi-district round at 6A football. Again, during the halftime break, we'll get you some more scores going on across the Rio Grande Valley. It was 35 seconds, then they burned two 10-second plays, and time stopped as they moved the chains, but Matt Kine being able to take off a timeout. So first and 10 here from the 42-yard line, quick pass once again to Keith, and they've been going to Tristan Keith a majority of these couple plays as he's been able to run out of bounds, and he's been having a lot of receptions so far. He's had three straight receptions. 8-yard reception. And stops time one more time here, and that's been the go-to move here for Matt Kine, Browns veterans. Looking to try to read that play as you'll see that coverage, and they'll find Keith, and Keith, this time with two coverage on him, two-man coverage. Max Fernandez and Tyson Rios that are playing defense on him. Rios, the primary man guarding Keith. Max Fernandez coming in to break up the pass. You see Rios right there, or you see Keith on the bottom of your screen. So third down and two from the 40-yard line. They'll hand off down the middle. It'll be a QB keeper by Valdez. Fake handoff going to a QB keeper. And time will stop one more time.
Timeout
going to be called.
Mackay.
And Mackay will burn out. second straight timeout again.
The first
interesting
half.
Why they're burning timeouts if time stops as they're moving up the chains. Just able to burn a second timeout again. Give you some more scores coming in with an early break to the halftime show, early intro to the halftime show. Which is what we've seen so far all night. Again, a very dominant offense. Dominant night by Brownsville Veterans Memorial. Gilbert Trillo, three touchdowns on the night for him. Mankai was able to find the groove early on late in the first. And he finally connected huge on that huge pass there from Valdez. The Alvarez, a 59-yard bomb to give the Bulldogs their first touchdown of the night. First and 10 here coming up from the 42-yard line. 14 seconds, one timeout remaining for the Bulldogs. 30-second timeout can get you more scores across the bi-district round. Again, it's been a rainy, wet day here. Temperature now dropping. It's 58 degrees and clear skies, but it's been a rainy day so far across the Rio Grande Valley. It was nonstop torrential rain in Brownsville, and it just dried up about an hour before kickoff. Since then, it's been clear skies and no rain coming in. Oh, first and 10 here from the 42-yard line. Valdez dropping back. He pump fakes. Here comes the pressure. Valdez shifts from his right to his left. Here goes on the move. He's going to go on a QB keeper now, and Valdez will get out of bounds. But 5 seconds left. All the moving around is only to be able to pick up 1 yard. So now it gets down to the 41-yard line and a 1 yard loss. This brings up second down and 9 with 5 seconds left to go. So second down and 9 coming up here with 5 seconds left. Valdez dropping back, possibly a deep pass coming in. Here comes the defense. He'll air this one out downfield, and now we'll run the time and one half in the books. 41-7, the end of the first quarter. We'll be back with the halftime break here at KBZI-TV's coverage of the 2023 UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoff by District Round between Matt Kine and Brownsville Veterans. We'll be back after this.
direction of Miss Rachel Castillo Ruiz. Steppers, the field is yours.
Officers for the Steppers are Captain Senior Nate Rodriguez, Showtime International All-Star, and Showmakers of America All-Star. First Lieutenant Senior Riley Alden, Showtime International and Showmakers of America All-Star. Second Lieutenant Junior Daniela Luna, Showtime International and Showmakers of America All-Star. Ladies and gentlemen, your stepper of the week is Natalie Aliceva. Steppers, it's all about you. Ladies and gentlemen, the McAllen High School is pleased to present the 2023 Parada 5, the showband of the Rio Grande. It's the Deadly band will perform Grandfather Clock and Paint Black. Drum major Derek Potter, the field is yours. Thank you.
gentlemen, thank you for your attention. This halftime performance by Matt Vivan is sponsored by the United States Coast Guard, who protects the men, saves Matt Vivan and his parents. Thank you, United States Coast Guard. Dean McAllen, high school baton, Bulldog band, is under the field direction of Ruel De La Cruz. He is assisted by George Sanchez, Sarah Cannon, Christopher Cruz, and Victor Casas. Color guard sponsors, Jennifer Rodriguez. Color guard instructor is Cynthia Baca. Additional instructional staff includes Sissy Gutierrez, Marty Gutierrez, Alex Morales, Juliana Gonzalez, and Freddie Gomez. Now, Matt Vivan fans, at this time, on your feet, as we honor our city and our community with the National Emblem March, the spelling of the Matt Vivan, and the McAllen High School fight song.
Thank you. will conclude their halftime performance with God Bless America. Veterans Memorial Principal, Ms. Noma Jean Canales. Stillman Middle School Principal, Sandra Cortez. Stillman Band Director, Victor Franco, Margo Gatti, Olga Manzano, and David Juanides. A special thanks to the Veterans Memorial Administrative Team, our teachers, and of course, our parents. A special thanks to our hardworking band members for their commitment to continued support. Good night, and as always, go Charger!
Fourth quarter score this evening, PSJ Bears 28, West Fresno Falcons 7. Flower Bluff Hornets 38, PSJ Memorial Wolverines 14. Third quarter score, Mission Mets Memorial Patriots 35, Battery View Tigers 0. Gregory Portman Wildcats 48, Roman Gladiators 10. Third quarter score, Edinburgh Villa 10, West Fresno East Wildcats 9. Halftime score still, Halligan Southhawks 7, McAllen Memorial Mustangs 7. Halftime score, West Eagle Panthers 20, Mission Eagles 0. Thank you.
Mic test.
Alrighty, back here. Welcome to the second half of Friday Night Football, coming to you live from Sam's Memorial Stadium in Brownsville, Texas. 2023 UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs.
Sergio Sanchez back to receive, number 22. Carinthian, number 3, Sanchez.
Brownsville Veterans Memorial here up 41-7 as we start off the second half between Brownsville Vets and Mack High. Mack High, they started the game off returning the ball. Here's a return by Trevilian. Trevilian returning it from the 19-yard line, running into traffic. Trevilian gets away from one. He's going to be finally spun out, and he's still going on his feet. Trevilian still stays up, and he's finally going to be brought down inside Mack High territory. So Mack High started off on offense in the first half. Brownsville Veterans, they won the toss, deferred to the second half. We weren't able to have a halftime show here to give way, make... And to make way for the halftime performers, we were to hold off the halftime show. But here's some scores around the Rio Grande Valley at the moment. 35-7 PSJ over Los Fresnos. And the 4A's Orange Grove up over Raymondville 28-9. We'll get you more as the night goes on. So first and 10 here from the 47-yard line. Montoya lined up under center. Montoya rolling off to his right-hand side. He goes on a QB keeper, and Montoya down to about the 44-yard line. Will pick up three and bring up second down and 7 here for Brownsville Vets. Brownsville Vets, a solid performance here. Star-studded first quarter and second quarter. 6 touchdowns in the first half. Second down and 7 here from the 44-yard line. Hand off to Trillo on the left-hand side. Trillo at the line of defenders. Trillo going to be shoved out of bounds. At about the 32-yard line. Some scores coming in here again. PSJ and Los Fresnos. That one 35-7. The Bears over the Falcons in the fourth quarter. Raymondville and Orange Grove. The Bulldogs up over the Bearcats 29-8 in the third quarter. Valley View and Mission Veterans 43-0 lead for the Patriots over the Tigers. You know, first and 10 coming up at the 32-yard line. Handoff to the right-hand side. Second down coming up. Again, more scores here. Wessico and Mission, 20-0 lead here for the Panthers over the Eagles. That one in the third quarter. Flower Bluff, Hornets over PSJ Memorial in the fourth, 38-14. Roma and Gregory Portland, 48-10 for the Gregory Portland Wildcats. For the Roma Gladiators. And they go across here, the right hand side. That's Belmontes. Cesar Belmontes on the carry. Belmontes down quickly to about the 13, 14 yard line. Frustrated down to your four rounds of Veterans of Moore. Again, they started off the first half on defense after deferring to receive the ball to the third quarter. Huge return by Trevilian to bring him back down to the 47-yard line. Belmontes on a handoff down the middle. Belmontes nowhere to go. Right down roughly to about the 12-yard line. A 2-yard pickup bringing up second down and 8 for Brownsville Vets. Port Isabel and Robstown, 28-21 lead for the Tarpons over Port Isabel, or over Robstown, 28-21, that one at the half. Most updated scores here as of late so far. Coming to you live from the Bi-District Round. We'll get you more scores as the night goes on. So second down and 8 here. Montoya lined up under center, man in motion, tossing off to the left-hand side. Trevilian. Trevilian trying to cut through traffic. A flag on the plane. Flag A flag on the play is Trevilian. Calvin Trevilian going down the left-hand side.
Holding on the offense, number 25. Spot foul,
holding
10 yards.
Against Brownsville veterans as Nico sees Nettles as sophomore call on a holding call. This brings up second down now coming up. On now going back all the way quickly here to the 14-yard line. So the original yard scrimmage to go second down and 10. Ranking down in 10 now coming up here, 9:24 left to go in the third quarter. Montoya and company lined up after that holding call against the Chargers. Second and 10, 9:15 left to play. Montoya to his right-hand side on a toss to Trillo. Trillo, a lot of room down the sideline. He's in. Touchdown, Brownsville veterans. And the Gilbert Trillo show continues here in the second half as he'll pick up his fourth touchdown of the night, his first since early on in the second quarter. A lot of room down the right-hand side. Montoya, a perfect toss executed as he finds Trillo. And Trillo, nothing but green grass and clear skies ahead of him as he drives it through. On drive number 8 on the night here, their first of the second half with 9:09 left to play. Here in this third quarter, Gilbert Trillo, touchdown number 4, 48-7. You're watching KBSD-TV's coverage of the Class 5A Division 1 Exodus High School Football State Playoffs.
Join Best AFT today because our working conditions are our students' learning conditions.
Texas Valley Educators Association represents approximately 1,500 members in Brownsville and Fergusville ISD. Members are privileged to have a local organization with local attorneys. Enjoy our benefits today and get to know us before you need us.
I know 9 left to play here in the third quarter. Gilbert Trillo continues his performance. 4 touchdowns on the night with 9:09 left to play here in the third quarter. Well, I'm going to be returning about the 15-yard line. Trying to drive that one back. There is Damon Lopez. Lopez trying to cut through traffic. Will finally be brought down roughly at about the 35-yard line. And Mackay, a very nightmarish start for them in the first half. They were started off slow in their first two drives. It was a 3-and-out and a 4th-and-1. They were shut down on 4th down.
On Brownsville Vets,
and then
face mask, 15 yards, and the run, first down.
Momentum going, they've been able to put the pieces together, and they finally found hope in a form of a 59-yard touchdown pass from Joaquin Valdez to Max Alvarez to make it 35-7. And on the next drive, Brownsville Veterans 8-7 drive, or Brownsville Veterans 6th drive of the night. McCallan High was able to shut him down and force a 3-and-out and make him lose about 7 yards. Valdez, quick pass to the right-hand side. Pass going to be completed across to Nick Haram. And Nick Haram going to be down roughly to about the 46-yard line for about a 4-yard pickup. Brings up second down and 6 here for Mackay. When they were struggling all night, they were finally able to get the gears in motion. But every time they had some momentum going, Brownsville veterans would shut the door. So here comes second down coming up and a huge first down and more for Mackay. Is on the carry right there. Jaden Aneta is going to be brought down to about the 33-yard line. Huge 13-yard gain brings up first and 10 for Mackay. And this Bulldog offense wasting no time as they go quickly to the play. Here's another handoff down the middle. Good move and trying to get across. On the carry is Aneta one more time, and this time he's down to the 28-yard line for a 5-yard pickup to bring up second and 5 for Mackay. And Mackay's first drive of the second half is a lot more efficient than we saw in the first half. Quick fire pass to the left-hand side. That's Aneta who shakes one. Aneta shakes another, and he's finally going to be brought down. He would get past two defenders, but Damian Rodriguez comes in from behind and brings him down. And once again, Mackay a lot more efficient than what we saw him in. It was those first couple drives. They were a little bit slow. Then they were able to get the ball rolling, the wheels turning. But every time they had momentum going, Brownsville veterans were able to shut them down, and they finally found the end zone in that 59-yard touchdown pass. And they carried that momentum into the next drive defensively on Brownsville's 6th drive of the night. They made the Chargers lose about 6 yards, and they forced a three and out for the first time. The only blemish Brownsville veterans has had offensively tonight. And ever since then, things were sort of stalled out for both teams. But we saw the Chargers, they were able to pick up two touchdowns, a 73-yard run by Trevilian, and, of course, the 8-yard run by Trillo earlier here in the third. Valdez rolling to his right-hand side. He'll blow down to the end zone. That's going to be caught by Keith, and Keith is in. Touchdown, McHigh. 23-yard touchdown pass, and the McHigh Bulldogs will quickly respond as they'll find their second touchdown tonight. As Valdez this time finds Tristan Keith, the junior, and that junior connection pays off as it's a 23-yard pass. Cash Casadez here lined up for the PAT. Low line drive kick up and in, and with 7:17 left to go, McHigh able to get on the board for the second touchdown pass of the night. 48-14, 7:17 left to play here in the third on KBZI TV's coverage of the Class 5A Division I UIL Texas High School Football State Playoffs.
Fourth quarter score, one of the South Hawks 10, McAllen Memorial Mustangs 7. Kicking out number 30, Cassidy's.
Forty-eight-14 as McHigh finds the end zone for a second time on the return here for Brownsville. Sanchez. Sanchez trying to cut through traffic will be brought down to about the 30-yard line. But McHigh, talk about the change of momentum. Quick and clean, you can call that drive, as they started off at the 30-yard line and were able to work their way down the field on key passes and those mainly or key rushes. A couple QB keepers, but it was Angel and Jaden Nedek, who powered the offense for McHigh. Eventually, it was capped off on a huge pass there, a 23-yard touchdown pass to Tristan Keith for McHigh's second touchdown, their second touchdown pass of the night. So first and 10 here from the 30-yard line, Chargers lining up. One receiver lined up on the left-hand side. Hand off down the middle. Trevilian on the carry. We saw Trevilian have a touchdown earlier. His first touchdown of the game, the last play of the game, or last play of the half for Brownsville Vets. That 73-yard touchdown run on first and 10 to make it a 41-7 game to end out the first half, for Brownsville Veterans. So second down and one on a 90-yard run by Trevilian. Montoya lined up under center. Rick Sosa now back in at quarterback. First and 10 coming up here as a frustrated downs here against Sergio Sosa, now taking snaps here in the second half for Brownsville Veterans. As they've been going to Trevilian, Cesar Belmontes lined up in the backfield. He may be the next target. He is. Belmontes trying to cut through. Belmontes tripped up and brought down to the 50-yard line. So second and 5 on the 5-yard gain by Cesar Belmontes, the sophomore running back. Second down and 5 here from the 50-yard line. Handing off to Belmontes. Belmontes on the left-hand side. A first down and more still going. And he's finally going to be brought down inside the 30-yard line. Or 35-yard line, excuse me. Make that to the 32. Cesar Belmontes, a sophomore coming up big. And he's had a couple touchdowns earlier this season. Had a couple carries, too. He's powered the offense, too. But it's been Trillo and Trevilian who've been carrying the workload, but we've seen Belmontes with a couple good carries, one of them right there to the 32-yard line. First and 10 with 5:27 and counting, play clock at 18 seconds. So Sun, another handoff here. This time to Belmontes again, and Belmontes another carry. You can tell Belmontes across, he's number 15, but he always wears a hoodie while he plays. Well, not exactly a hoodie, but those thin undershirts with a hood. You can call it hoodie, technically. Second down and five here to the 27-yard line. Sosa lined up under center. They go once again to Belmontes, and Belmontes trapped. And down to about the 24-yard line. So about roughly a 3-yard pickup. 3-yard pickup, bringing up third down and two here. Four Brownsville vets. Mackay looking to shut down the Brownsville veterans offense here. And you see the kicker there, Ramon Reyna, lining up, practicing some kicks. They go to Belmontes. Belmontes trying to stretch across, and he does. And just enough for the first down, and Browns veterans renews the drive as they move the chains. Ending off down the middle to Trevilian. Trevilian chopped and brought down. Mira is there on the tackle.
5-yard gain.
Second and five to the 15-yard line. Up to the left-hand side. Diego Barrera there on the tackle to Trevilian.
Officials timeout for an injury.
Injury timeout here. Take a quick break here on KBSDI TV. Here, 3:12 left to go in this third quarter. A quickly moving third quarter. Both teams have really had one drive. Bronzo Vets on their second drive of the night. It's Mackay who scored on their first drive of the night. In the second half, it was a Valdez to Keith 23-yard touchdown pass. And Trello started off the scoring for the Chargers in this third quarter with an 8-yard touchdown run. Make it 48-7. Then quickly, a couple plays later, Valdez found Keith to respond for Mackay. 48-14 with 3:12 left to go. 7:17 since it was the last touchdown scored. It's been 4 minutes and 5 seconds since they've had a touchdown. It's been a very lengthy drive so far for Brownsville veterans. That's what the Chargers do. They can eat up as much of the time, eat up as much of the clock as possible.
34 for the Chargers.
Third down and four now coming up here for Brownsville Vets. Take over at the Mackay 15-yard line. Third and four. They've been very efficient on the conversion so far tonight. Handing off to Trevilian, and Trevilian chopped up. And Trevilian down to the 10-yard line, able to pick up 5 yards. That sets a first and goal down here quickly for Brownsville Vets, and the Chargers have been very efficient on those first and goal plays.
5-yard gain, first and goal at the 10-yard line.
Been 5 touchdowns. Five out of their 7 touchdowns have all been inside the 10-yard line. First and goal from the 10-yard line. Sosa going deep down to the corner. That's going to be complete. They're looking to find Joseph Brock, the junior wide receiver, the intended target. Again, Browns awareness has been very dangerous inside the 10. And 5 of their 7 touchdowns have been all from inside the 10-yard line. Their own two touchdowns have been passed the 10-yard line, where that's that 40 to 75-yard touchdown pass to Trillo. And the 73-yard run by Trevilian early on. Second down and 10 here from the 10 coming up. Or second and goal for the 10. Hand off to Belmontes, and Belmontes is in. Touchdown, Browns Vets. And Cesar Belmontes, a sophomore, will get into the mix with his first touchdown of the night on a 10-yard run on second and goal. Four minutes and 56 seconds before the since the last touchdown. The kick is up, and that's going to be good. But it's Cesar Belmontes here on 2:21 left to go in the third. A 10-yard run on second and goal here on KBSD-ITV. So welcome back here to KBSD-ITV, coming to you live from Samson World Stadium for coverage of the 2023 Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs. So now six of the eight touchdowns, four Browns veterans have come inside the 10-yard line. Cesar Belmontes, a sophomore, gets in the mix on a 10-yard touchdown run to make it 55-14. Sky-high kick as we return here in the third quarter. Trying to return that one back there, Damon Lopez. Damon Lopez down to about the 33-yard line. McHigh, they took over from about the 34-yard line last time, and they powered their way down the field, and they capped it off as Joaquin Valdez found Tristan Keith on a 23-yard touchdown pass to make it 48-14. And it was a quick response after Brownsville veterans opened up the third with an 8-yard run by Gilbert Trillo. Trillo with four touchdowns tonight, three rushing touchdowns and one reception. The reception being a 75-yard pass. Make it 21-0 in the first quarter. Valdez lined up in the shotgun. Three receivers on his right. It'll be a QB keeper. Five receivers in play. Three on his right, two on his left-hand side. He goes for a keeper, and then he picks up a total of 2 yards. Bring up second down and 8 here. Ball now at the 35-yard line in McHigh territory. With just 2 minutes left to go in this third quarter, very quickly moving third quarter. It was 4 minutes and 56 seconds. After Valdez found Keith in the end zone, Belmontes for BVM responded. And that ground strike offense can take a lot of time up off the field. So second down and 8, 1:43 left to play. Valdez dropping back, pulls a bullet down the middle. That's going to be caught. Going on the move right there is De Saavedra. De Saavedra still going. He'll shake off a defender, and he's finally going to be caught up to. Down to about the 12-yard line. Gilbert Trillo bringing him down. But a huge play there right there. A huge reception by Diego De Saavedra, the senior. And a flag on the play, so he hold the phone momentarily.
53-yard reception.
53 yards gained there on the reception to Diego De Saavedra.
Personal foul. Face mask on the defense, number one. Half a distance to the goal. First down.
Face mask call against Gilbert Trillo.
First and goal from the six-yard line
here. We'll move him up. So initially from the 13, 7 yards forward. Quick handoff down the middle. They'll get down here to the back to the 6 yard line. So no gain or loss. Brings up second and goal. So Veda on the stop there against Herrera. Jaden Herrera now back in again. The majority of the first half, it was Angel and Nye who was running the ball. And now Herrera back in the mix. Valdez dropping back. They're going to go for a pass. That's going to be batted away. Was looking to find a pass in the corner. The end's looking to find Alvarez again. And Joseph Brock broke it up. With 59 seconds left to play here in this third quarter. Now third and goal coming up from the 6 yard line. It can be an opportunity wasted for Mackay, but they're unable to capitalize on excellent field positioning here with 36 coming up. Play clock at 14 seconds. Valdez and company looking towards the Mackay sideline, trying to get the play call. 7 seconds left before the play clock expires. 59 seconds left in this game. Trying to get the snap off in time. They do. Valdez, quick pass into the end zone. Picked off! That's Trillo on the interception. Now Trillo driving it back. And he's going to be forced out of bounds. And just like that, a turning the momentum here is good pass down the middle. They were looking to connect that ball across here. And Nick Karam, but Gilbert Trillo comes through and picks it off and drives it back all the way to the 29-yard line. And once again, that example we've seen all night where Mackay, they get the ball rolling, the wheels turning, they get the momentum flowing. And Browns Veterans Memorial will quickly shut the door, slam the door shut on you. And Gilbert Trillo turning the momentum around right there with the 29-yard interception, driving it back to the 29. Sosa and company back in, first and 10 from the 29. Hand off to Trevilian. Trevilian going to be brought down here to about the 34-yard line. Picking up five, brings up second down and five with 41 left to go here in this third quarter. And Gilbert Trillo there on the pick. Second down and five coming up. Making it back to the line of scrimmage, no gain or loss. Brings up third down and five. The final 5 seconds will tick away.
That will be the end of the third quarter of the score. Chargers 55.
So 3 quarters in the books. 36 minutes of football complete. 12 more to go. We go to the fourth here on KBSDI-TV. Covering your live coverage of the UIL Class 5A Division 1 Texas High School Football State Playoffs. And it's 55-14 to go to the fourth. Down and five here, start of the fourth quarter. Toss off to the right-hand side, and Trevilian going to be tripped up, and this brings up fourth down as we think we're looking into the fourth quarter here. 14-point score, 2 touchdowns by Brownsville Vets in that third quarter. Mackay picking up the 1 touchdown in that third as well. Score at the end of the third quarter, 55-14. 2 touchdowns scored by Brownsville Vets and one by Mackay in the third. For joining us here, Ruben Rodriguez with you on the call, coming to you live from Sounds and World Stadium for KBSDI-TV's coverage of the 2023 5A State Playoffs. And the rain starting to come down here. A bit of a heavy downpour as the skies finally open up. Here's a deep pass downfield. That's going to be, or the punt, excuse me, my Brownsville veterans. Distracted by the rain momentarily, and it was actually just punt out of the throw. So Mackay will take over from their own 26-yard line, but they were able to pick up a touchdown early in the second quarter on that 59-yard pass from Valdez-Alvarez, and then they pick up a touchdown quickly to respond after Bronzo Veterans opened up the third of the touchdown. It was Valdez who found Tristan Keith for a 23-yard pass. They had a chance. They were knocking on the door once again. And all of a sudden, Gilbert Trillo picks up a 29-yard interception. First and 10 here for Mackay from the 27-yard line. They hand off to Adeda. They're not going to be brought down to the 33-yard line. Picks up a gain of 6, brings up second down and 4 as the skies finally open up. The skies finally open up here at Sounds Memorial Stadium as the rain starts coming in. Ball throw downfield. Temperature now back in the low 60s. 61 degrees, light rain coming in. And it was like this the majority of the day. You know, when I woke up this morning, I made a drive here to Brownsville. It was about clear, very cloudy. No rain. And then I remember I got inside the building and then I left. And then I left. And then the rain started coming in a lot more.
Pass complete to number three, Keith.
So Keith there on the reception brings up fourth down. So fourth down coming up, fourth down and one. Special teams unit is back on board again. The rain now coming down, torrential rain.
Timeout, Mack High.
And Mack High,
the first timeout in the second half.
In a lot of rain, a cold front coming in here in the Rio Grande Valley. A lot of rain expected. It's not no heavy thunderstorms we expected. We thought it were not this week. Thought it was going to be some heavy thunderstorms, but it's all been nothing but light rain. And this morning when I woke up and made the drive over here, it was nothing but clear skies. And throughout the day, it was just a light downpour that just kicked in the whole night. Right downpour that kicked in all day, and then right about an hour before kickoff, the rain just let off. Clear skies up until now, the light rain increasing just a bit, but it's nonstop, and that was how it was the majority of the day before, an hour before kickoff. So timeout called by Matt Kai here, but again, rain now coming down, 61 degrees. So the interim weather report is we're expecting this weather from the rest of the night. Again, a cold front that's making its way across the valley, bringing in some light rain. So fourth and one. Line drive punt. This one with no one back to return. It has a lot of leg on it. Has a chance to make it down inside to the five, and they're trying to wave it off. Down to the 4 yard line. Saw Alexander Corpus alongside Damon Lopez both waving and trying to make some more air with whatever they can to help. First and 10 here now from the 4 yard line. Again, the sky, we're just tuning in, the sky is opening up. Rain coming down here at Sam Stadium. After three quarters of the way, it was clear skies. Clear skies, no rain. Handoff on the first and 10. Trevilian on the carry, brought down quickly, roughly to about the 12-yard line. And roughly 8 yards picked up by Trevilian.
Trevilian tackled by number two, Devon Lopez.
Second down and two coming up. Hand off to the right-hand side. So Montes on the carry. Let's get you some more scores coming in across the Rio Grande Valley.
12-yard gain, first and 10 at the 24.
Dealey up over Santa Rosa, 28-0 in the fourth quarter. Edinburgh Vale over Wesco East, 31-9. 34-30. Forestville over Robstown. Forestville still trying to hold on to that one. Game gone final. Flower Bluff knocks off PSJ Memorial. In the 5A Division 2 action. Mission Veterans knocks off Valley View 43-6. PSJ knocked off Los Fresnos earlier. So we'll open up the bracket and we'll see who each team will be playing. Second down and 12 from the 22-yard line. Trying to carry that ball down the middle. Down to the 30-yard line. Big gain right there. A gain of about six.
Montes
Almonte is on the carry. Brings up third down and four now coming up here for the Chargers. Trying to go down the middle.
Officials timeout for injury.
A player down. We'll take a quick break here on KBZI-TV. Final score coming in, Harlingen South knocking off McAllen Memorial. The first time under Izzy Gonzalez, the Hawks make it to the area round. They were shut down in the Bi-District in 2021 against PSJ North. Last year, they fell to Mack High in the Bi-District. Now this year, they make it to the area round for the first time under Izzy Gonzalez. So we'll tell you who each team is playing. We'll look at the 5-District and the 5A. San Benito knocked off Edinburgh North, so they were either taking on the winner between Rader United and San Antonio Taft. But if we look at the 5A Division 1 action, looking at the 5A Division 1 bracket. Second down and 10 coming up here from the 36-yard line. Winner of this one takes on Corpus Christi. Lorenzo Veterans will take on Corpus Christi. Veterans one. Here's a play down the sideline. Take on Gutierrez on the tackle. First and 10 here from the 45-yard line after a game by Brownsville Veterans Memorial. So as we look at the bracket here, Brownsville Veterans, if they're able to hold on with 6:06 left to play, they'll take on Corpus Christi.
Time
Veterans
out.
Will knock down San Antonio Brownsville Southwest 29-7.
First team timeout in the second half.
PSJ North, who got rid of Donna, will be taking on Victoria East to defeat Medina Valley 35-13. Lingbergh Vela, verge of beating Westego East, will take on Corpus Christi Miller. Arlington South will take on the winner of Arlington South after knocking off Cal Memorial. Will take on the winner of Victoria West and San Antonio Southside here in Region 3. So again, South will take on either Southside or Victoria West. Edinburgh Velo will take on Corpus Christi Miller. PSJ North takes on Victoria East. Corpus Christi Veterans will take on Brownsville Veterans as those 5A Valley teams move on. PSJ North, Edinburgh Velo. So PSJ North, Edinburgh Vela, Harlington South, and Brownsville Veterans, the 5A Division 1 teams who make it to the area round. Again, we'll break down more of it later as the night goes on. 6:06 up to play here. As again, Harlington South, if you're just tuning in, has defeated PSJ or McAllen Memorial 10-7. New quarterback also in here for the Chargers. Javier Devetta, the sophomore, third-string quarterback, getting in some snaps. Trying to keep the rotations warm. Sergio Sosa pulled out of the game. It was Storm Montero was pulled out earlier. .544 left to go. We look at the 6A bracket as well. Trying to cut through on the handoff. six save bracket. Los Fresnos knocking off, or PSJ knocking off Los Fresnos. They'll take on the winner of Laredo United South and San Antonio Brennan. Westlake takes on Round Rock. Whoever wins that one plays against San Antonio Reagan and East Central High. And Sam Nito, of course, beat Edinburgh North. Later, take on the Laredo United or San Antonio Taft in the area round. We get the Fire Division 2 momentarily. And off to the right hand side. Jerry Hadamil, the junior running back, coming in. Brought down, fourth down coming up. Fourth and four here now. Coming up four rounds of Veterans Memorial.
Fourth and six.
And we'll tell you more about the 5A bracket momentarily. So fourth and six coming up with 4:28 left to go in this fourth quarter. 2 yard loss here by the Chargers. Again, new quarterback in the mix, Javier Vera. Jaramillo lined up in the backfield. And a flag on the play. They're waving it off as a timeout. Fourth and six coming up here. 3:53 left to go.
Ball goes over and downs.
So Matt Kai gets back up on defense here. First and 10. They'll take over at the 43-yard line. A bit of a disorganization going on there. Handoff down to the right-hand side, and quick stop right there by Brownsville Vets. Second down coming up here for Mack High. Handoff to the left-hand side. It's third down now coming up. Down and seven coming up here with 3:02 left to go. Matt Kyle on offense. Hand off down to the left hand side. QB keeper by Valdez, who rolls to his right-hand side. Valdez, he's stepping out of bounds here with 2:22 left to go. Down and 10 coming up. Quick fire pass. Down on the left-hand side. That's going to be completed. A good move. Obed Alvarez there on the reception. Alvarez having that first touchdown pass for Mackay early on in the second quarter. Two offensive plays they had. It was also Valdez finding Keith.
Tackled
So 1.5 left to play here. Keith on the reception renews the drive here. First and 10. Four Matt Kies are now inside the red zone at the 19. Rain beginning to come down more and more. Valdez firing one on the move. That's going to be complete intended for Diego de Saavedra. And the Saavedra couldn't quite bring that one down. Brings up second down and 10 here from the 18-yard line with 1:26 left to play. Again, Browns of Veterans will take on Corpus Christi Veterans, who knocked off Southwest 29-7. And brought down here all the way inside to the 10-yard line.
First and goal to the 7-yard line.
The 7 to be exact, with 1:13 left to go. Time winding down. Matt Kaya can possibly get one more touchdown in. QB keeper by Valdez. Valdez shakes one off and he's brought down. Back to the 6-yard line for a 1-yard gain. Brings up second and goal on a 1-yard pickup by Valdez. And the Browns are better in 6. Final minute of action here. Valdez lobs one in the back of the end zone. Caught. Touchdown, Mackay, and Valdez. The 6-yard touchdown pass to Alvarez. The second connection for them tonight with 56. 35 seconds left to go. Valdez finding Max Alvarez. Meaning a 6-yard TD pass. That being the lone touchdown of the fourth quarter. Cash Gossett is lining up for the PAT. It is up and it is good. And 55-21 with 35 seconds left to go. Mackay, their season almost coming close to an end. They'll finish off
offside.
Their season.
On their defense,
overall,
penalty decline.
It's all the points. Brownsville Veterans on the verge of capturing their bi-district title. Capturing their next bi-district title, their third straight bi-district title again. They had a share of the district championship last year with Harlingen South and Westego East. And Westego East was knocked out by Vela. Harlingen South moves on and takes on. Taking on either San Antonio or Victoria East. We'll tell you more about that right now momentarily.
Timeout. Brownsville Vets. That's the second team timeout in the second half.
Timeout called by Brownsville Vets, so we'll take advantage of the timeout and we'll show you quickly one more time. We're plenty of you. So Corpus Christi Veterans knocked off Southwest 29-7 last night, or earlier today. Mackay and Brownsville Veterans Memorial. Brownsville Veterans Memorial 35 seconds away from reaching the area where they'll take on Corpus Christi Vets. Corpus Christi Vets, of course, the team that knocked off PSJ North, who then knocked off Brownsville Veterans prior to that. PSJ North knocking off Donna 45-7. They'll take on Victoria East, who knocked off Medina Valley 35-13. Corpus Christi Miller knocked off Laredo Martin 77-0. And they'll be taking on Edinburgh Velo, who defeated Westego East. 31-9. In Harlingen South and McCown Memorial, the Hawks knocking off the Mustangs 10-7. We'll take on either South Side, San Antonio South Side, or Victoria West. It's the 5A Division I Valley teams remaining. Brownsville Veterans, Arlington South, PSJ North, and Edinburgh Vela, who will have dates with Corpus Christi teams and San Antonio teams. Again, one more time, Arlington South, Edo takes on San Antonio South side of Victoria West. Edinburgh Vela takes on Corpus Christi Miller, PSJ North taking on Victoria East. And Brownsville Veterans taking on Corpus Christi Veterans. 28 seconds left to go. As the Chargers begin to get into victory formation, but a dominant performance here. To 21, your final score. Here the game, give to Gilbert Trillo. Trillo with four touchdowns on the night. As the Chargers get into victory formation. Oh, Brownsville Veterans brings home the bi-district crown. The massive win as they'll take on Corpus Christi Veterans Memorial. You're joining us here on KV's the ITV's coverage of the last 5A Division I Texas High School Football Playoffs. It's Brownsville Veterans who wins this one, 55-21. Thank you for joining us on KV's the ITV. Final score, Veterans Memorial Chargers 55.